grace and peace of God our Father, and the love of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Good people, we've come today to this church with great joy for this celebration. And now we stand with Maggie and Andrew on the day they intend to begin a home of their own. Of course, for them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, our friendship, and our prayer. Let us also listen tenderly with them to the Word of God. And then with the church, let us humbly pray to God through Jesus for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly accept them, bless them, and make them always one. We pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these, your servants, Andrew and Maggie, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love with one another. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated by the Lord's word.
Reading from the Song of Songs. The voice of my beloved. Look, here he comes, springing across the mountains, leaping across the hills. My lover is like a gazelle, a young stag. Here he stands behind our wall, gazing through the windows, peering through the lattice. My beloved speaks. He says to me, arise, my love, my beautiful one, and come. O dove in the clefts of the rock, in the secret recesses of the cliff, let me see you, let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet, and you are lovely. My beloved belongs to me, and I to him. He says to me, set me as a seal on your heart, as a seal on your arm, for stern as death is love, relentless as the netherworld is devotion. Its flames are a blazing fire. Deep waters cannot quench love, nor floods sweep it away. The word of the Lord.
Let's go. A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but I do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing. It bears all things. It believes all things. It hopes all things. And it endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I love you. Live on in my love. You'll live in my love if you keep my commandments, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and live in his love. And this is my commandment, love one another. The way I love you, there's no greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. And you're my friends if you do what I command you to do. I don't call you servants anymore, because the servant doesn't know what his master is doing. I call you friends, because I've told you everything that I have heard from my Father. You didn't choose me. I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit. Fruit that will last. So so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I'm giving you these commands so that you may love one another. The Gospel of the Lord. But generally speaking, it's not good to be alone, you know, so chronically alone, so visibly alone. That's not a good thing. In fact, I think for most people who live that way, for whatever reason, it's a kind of tragedy. Indeed, in another place, the Lord says it's not good for people to be alone. In 10,000 different ways. Maybe she likes the way the sunshine falls on his forearms. Perhaps they remind her of the strength and the security she feels in her father's presence. Maybe he likes the way the hair falls down her shoulder. Maybe they hear something, a certain something in each other's voice. Perhaps it's dependence, maybe it's independence, maybe it's naivete, maybe it's experience, maybe it's a special kind of intelligence. Who can say? But it slams into them, and they find themselves in that thing called love. And oh, once they're there, it's most compelling. You ever had a really bad sugar bite? Try to ignore it. You can't do it. And so Scripture is so wise when it says that stern as death is love, and relentless as the desert world is love. Its flames aren't just any old flames, they're a raging fire that the deepest blood cannot quench. And of course, love, your love, is a complicated undertaking. It's complicated, and like any complicated human undertaking, it will demand continuous investment. Even as it produces all kinds of fruit, emotional, physical, its harvest will change from one season of life to the next. And like the most blessed people in the world say, you know, the ones that are really good at loving, as wonderful as your love is when it's young, like fine wine, it can be when it's old. That's how all of us in here hope you find your love. But you must remember also that love is a self-effacing business. It demands a lot of capitulation, a lot of sacrifice. That's why the Apostle says that love is never self-seeking, it's never rude, it's never arrogant, it's never proud, it's never pompous. Instead, it endures everything, it can endure everything, and it can hope for everything because it knows how to be patient and kind, even as it is relentless and stern. Really, God is love. is God. Love is Jesus Christ, reflected in your own lives. Whatever plans you have today, whatever pleasure you take in one another, those of us who walked into this building this afternoon, who are believing, praying people, hope for you right now that you will dedicate yourself to becoming the presence of Jesus Christ in each other's lives. If you do that, you will be dedicating yourselves to the best course of life, one that will almost inevitably bring you happiness, and one that is bound to make you wise. We are grateful to God for the love between the two of you. We thank you for your courage to engage it. May you be blessed in it today. May all of us be blessed in it today and tomorrow. Thanks for your attention. Now for the private party, please. Church's minister in this assembled community, you may declare your intentions to marry, and that you may be strengthened by the Lord through the sacred seal of matrimony. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you, and through this special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he's already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever as they assume the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to stay in your intentions. Maggie and Andrew, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, really and wholeheartedly?
Yes, we did.
Are you prepared to follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it's your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your hands and declare your consent before God and the church. I, Andrew William Loudon.
I, Andrew William Loudon.
Take you, Margaret Jean Steiner.
Take you, Margaret Jean Steiner.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to honor you.
To love and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Margaret Jean Steiner.
I, Margaret Jean Steiner.
Take you, Andrew William Loudon.
Take you, Andrew William Loudon.
To be my husband.
My husband.
I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love and to honor you all the days of my life. May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you declared before the church, and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God has joined, let no one put asunder. Let us bless the Lord, say, thanks be to God. We pray the Lord bless these rings, which we bring today in honor of the love between this man and woman. May Maggie and Andrew always live together in peace, harmony, and love.
Please respond with the word in our prayer. For Andrew and Maggie and all married couples who live and believe that one plus one can truly equal more than two through love, respect, and lifelong friendship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who gather here to support this couple on this special day, for the people of Visitation Parish, and for our sister parish, Santa Maria Madre of Los Pobres in El Salvador. May those with much continue to share our resources where needed most and grow through our mutually enriching partnerships. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Don, Tracy, Bob, Teresa, and for all parents who have worked from the next generations, with deep gratitude for their love and wisdom, generosity and support, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the world to live in peace, with mutual respect for our differences and willingness to listen and understand when we disagree, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have preceded us to heaven, Don Loudon, Sr., Dale and Betty Ludlam, Marlon and Margaret Steiner, and for Frank Parker, Sr. While with us, they taught us to love each other and to love life each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Now I invite the bridegroom to kneel for the nuptial blessing. Brothers and sisters, let us humbly invoke by our prayers God's blessing upon this bride and groom, that in his kindness God may favor with his help those on whom he has bestowed the sacrament of marriage. Loving God, maker of all the world, who created woman and man in your own image, and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing, we beseech you to these your servants today joined in marriage. May your abundant blessing come down upon Maggie and Andrew, making them companions for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out together the gift of marriage, they may enrich the church. In happiness, may they praise you. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know you're here to comfort them in their needs. Let them pray to you in the Holy Assembly, and bear witness to you in the world. And after a happy old age, together with a circle of friends that surround them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please stand. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church." Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. And endless unity with our God. And And may God bless and keep you.